The SnapGene Action Menu gives you access to many tools to help you design, validate, and implement your experiments. It includes tools for cloning simulation, tools to simulate ligation, tools for design primers for PCR, and tools to simulate transcription or translation. Each cloning tool in the Action Menu is specialized, but they all follow the same basic logic. Let's use Gibson assembly with two inserts as an example. Start the cloning tool, and SnapGene will display Vector, Fragment, and Product tabs. First, in the Vector tab, you define how you linearize the vector, using restriction sites or PCR. Do it by selecting enzyme sites, as in Gibson guide lesson. Next, the Fragments tab allows you to set the number of inserts, choose the source file, and define the region to use. And finally, in the Product tab, use Choose Overlapping PCR Primers to have SnapGene automatically design appropriate primers based on your preferred PCR and Gibson assembly conditions. Once primers are designed, the bottom panel shows the overlaps and expected final product. Once you're happy with the construct, simply click Assemble and create a new product file. For a more detailed walkthrough of Gibson assembly, check out our Gibson assembly video. The PCR tools work similarly. It allows you to define a target sequence, and SnapGene will then design appropriate primers for amplification and generate the PCR product. The anneal oligos tool allows you to simulate creation of a double-stranded linker by annealing of overlapping complementary oligonucleotides. There are commands to circularize or linearize a sequence, convert between double-stranded or single-stranded sequence, convert between DNA and RNA, and finally, translate a selected coding sequence to create a protein sequence. And that's a brief introduction to the SnapGene Actions menu. Watch the rest of the videos in this Getting Started series at snapgene.com to learn more.